microforks between different producers. In this video, we're going to explain what are microforks and how we can avoid them and what are their cause. So here's a graph of a microfork. What happened is that you have producer A producing a few blocks, tick, 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 and producer B did not receive those blocks in time. So he started producing a block off of that one. He didn't see this one and this one and this one. So he created a chain that eventually was longer than this one. This means this block here was not paid to producer A, this one and this one either. So they're highly incentivized to work together to get better connectivity. Now the reason for that is that, you know, with a fast blockchain like EOS with 0.5 seconds between blocks, it can take some time for a block to traverse the transoceanic cables to get to the other side of the world, right? So if you're, Montreal and you're shipping blocks to Taiwan, well, there's a little time involved. So we need to have good peering between block producers, and block producers work a lot tirelessly day and night to ensure good speed of connectivity. Now, what is the risk for transactions? Is that if you have a transaction that was put inside this block here, right? And you can imagine it's gonna be put in that block because it was waiting in the memory for that producer. It was only included there. But what happens if the transaction expired at 5 here, right? It means it would not be included in 6. So you had confirmation your block, your transaction was in a block, but boom, it's forked out and it's not inside the history anymore. So you need to handle that. That's the feature of an eventually consistent database, right? So the team here is working on some tools, streaming APIs, to give you a clear view and a linear view of what's happening with your transactions so you can get greater assurance and guarantees out of that streaming data. Check it out, it's at diffuse.io. There's a lot of great features, table deltas. We have all the streaming and REST APIs augmented, that and much more, check it out. And by the way, we released a tool to explore those microforks. Take a look at this at grapher.eoscanada.com. You can punch in the number of blocks and then hit submit, and it's going to generate a nice graph of what really happened. Over here, we're seeing blocks that were produced in the schedule for EOS New York, and then someone has been eating those blocks, coming very late, and then eating that previous block here, and then missing some spots also. So what happened, maybe Node EOS failed, or the CPU was too loaded, or something like that. If we take a look at this one here, we see that this one has also in the block, maybe network latency between the end of the schedule, block 12 and 10. So take a look at that, grapher.eoscanada.com, to explore these microforks. So we saw about microforks, why they happen, and then what is their effect on the transactions, why we don't want them to happen, and how block producers are working tirelessly. Recently, you might have seen the numbers shrink. They're working to have great connectivity, to have a flawless blockchain. And I hope this helps. We'll see you around. Come to our Telegram channel, come to our Twitter, ba-da-da, and we'll see you next time.